Hello. So we continue our investigation of the specification of the deterministic parts of the utility function. And so far, we have seen a lot of specification based on the linear in parameter specification. We have seen that it can allow us to model quite rich behavioral assumptions already. But sometimes it's not sufficient. Sometimes we are willing to go beyond that and to use nonlinear specifications. This is the topic of this video, is to understand what kind of nonlinear specification we can use and what are the behavioral implications of this specification. Okay, let's take an example to understand why we are interested in nonlinear specification. Take again the example of a transportation mode choice and the impact of travel time to the choice of the mode of transportation. And then compare a case where you have the choice between a trip of 5 minutes with a trip of 10 minutes, and another context where you compare a trip of 2 hours and a trip of 2 hours and 5 minutes. In both cases, the difference is 5 minutes, meaning that in both cases, when you will calculate the probability, the 5 minutes will play the same role. But you may argue that 5 more minutes for a trip of 5 minutes will be actually perceived as more penalizing than 5 more minutes in the context of a 2-hour trip. This is what we would like to model, the fact that 1 more minute of travel time will not be perceived the same way by the traveler for short trips and for long trips. How do we do that? Well, one possibility would be to model the utility function as a function of travel time in a nonlinear way. For instance, in this example, the utility function is the logarithm of the travel time. So if you take this logarithm formulation and look at the impact of the utility function of an additional minute for short trips and of 1 additional minute for long trips, you realize that the impact on the utility function will be higher for short trips than for long trips. So this is due to the nonlinearity of the logarithm. And this is exactly what we would like to model. We would like to model the fact that an additional minute impacts more the utility for short trips than for long trips. So this looks very appropriate. So we can now compare the two specifications. In the first one, the assumption is that the marginal impact of travel time is constant. So this is what we did before, where the utility is a linear function of time. And now we would like to model the second assumption, that the marginal impact of travel time decreases with travel time. And this is where we propose the logarithm of time as a variable. Well, what is interesting to see here is that we are back to a linear in parameter specification. Actually, this logarithm can be pre-computed. You can take your data file, create a new column that you call log of time, and you calculate the logarithm of the variable time before you start the estimation. Okay, so this is nice. So it's possible to account for a nonlinear specification of the variable, but still having a linear in parameter specification of the utility function. Of course, in this case, the variables will have different units, so the value and the interpretation of beta will be completely different, but it's not a big issue. So the discussion we had with the interaction of the variables applies as well for nonlinear transformation of the variables. This can be pre-processed to account for these nonlinearities. So in general, all the variables that you can include in the model can be complex functions of all attributes and all socioeconomic characteristics. So in the slides, I denote these transforms using H. So H can be a nonlinear function of the existing variables. But again, they are pre-processed. They can be pre-calculated. And what we saw in the previous video about interactions between attribute and socioeconomics are just a special case of the H function. Okay, so this is nice, but the logarithm may also look arbitrary. Why logarithm? They are over nonlinear specifications. So let's investigate other ways to capture the same thing, the same behavioral assumptions that 1 minute of travel time will not affect the utility the same way for short trips and long trips.